All right, so the next topic I want to talk about at a very broad level are distributions. Distributions are going to be with us the whole semester. And really all the stuff early on here is all stuff that's really fundamental, foundational, that we'll build upon as we go forward. So distributions are how data sets are distributed. And we'll get more through what we'll talk more about what that means for a while. All right, so let's work with an example scenario here. So let's say over Christmas break, I counted the number of cookies that a bunch of the kids at the Christmas party ate. And so X, the variable, is the number of cookies eaten, right? So this is a ratio variable because you can't eat negative one cookie. And also it's a discrete variable, we'll say, because everybody, I only counted whole cookies that were eaten. If they ate half a cookie, I didn't even include it, right? So one kid ate one, another one ate three, another kid ate six, a couple of them ate four, one ate three, one ate two, and another one ate three. So here is our data set, all right? And so now we want to figure out like how it's distributed. And so one way to do that, to summarize this data, is with a frequency table, right? And so for that, what we're gonna do is we're gonna have one column that is for the different values of these scores, and another one that is the count. We could have put like an F there for frequency, which means the same thing as count. Put another line there if we want to make it look good, right? So the highest score is six, so we'll go on down. Four, three, two, one is the lowest. So here's the values that are within the range, including those that, like nobody had a five, but I still included it here. And you'll want to do that too when you create these frequency tables. Right, so now we're gonna count how many of each of these values showed up. So there was one, six, one kid ate six cookies. For fives, there's no kids ate five cookies. Two kids had four cookies. One, two, three kids had three cookies. One kid had two cookies, and only one had one cookie. There it is, that's the frequency table. So this has the exact same information as this, except for it's just organized in a different way. All right, so this is all the values for the variable of how many cookies the kid ate or at the Christmas party, right? And if we want to find out, well, how many kids ate four cookies, then you just go over to this column, two kids ate four cookies. How many kids ate three or four cookies? Well, three ate three cookies, three ate four. So if you add these up, five kids had three or four cookies, right? So this is a frequency table. Really, you mostly see these when you're doing preliminary evaluation of your data set, so you don't see something like this in a research paper or anything like that. But the next thing that we're going to talk about is something that you'll see quite a bit, and that is a histogram. And these are actually often referred to as distributions. So all semester we're going to be talking about distributions, and I think every time we say the word distribution from here on in, we're going to mean a histogram, right? And so a histogram is a way to visually display the data in the data set, and it's actually kind of a summary of this. So for this, what we're going to create is a vertical and a horizontal axis, and this is going to have to be high enough. So this is going to be our count, and let's say zero, and the top is three, so I just want to mark these, so one and two. And across the bottom, we're going to put all of our values. One, two, three, four, five, and six. And these were number of cookies eaten. Okay, so next we'll want to create bars that correspond to the height of each of these values. So we'll start at the top here. So for six, it only goes up to one. So there's a bar here that goes up to one. There was 0.5, so we don't need a bar. For four, there's two. That looks like about two. There was three threes. One, two, and 1, 1. That is the histogram for this frequency table or this data set. Right, so if we look at it, we can see that right away the mode is 3. I'm not sure what the average is, but it's probably between 3 and 4. And the median is going to be 3 also. Take 1, 2, 3 off, 1, 2, 3 off, and there's a whole bunch of 3s left in the middle. And these distributions have various characteristics that we're going to talk about. And there's even some special distributions, like the normal distribution, that has a lot of characteristics that we care about, and we're going to be using the normal distribution throughout the whole semester, pretty much. All right, so it's a really basic introduction to some fundamental concepts for distributions. Okay, that's that one. So next I want to talk about a little more complicated situation. And for this, I've already drawn up or written up the data set. So let's say these are the number of words that students had in an essay. So this student had 339 words in their essay. This one had 180. And so these are all each different essays and the number of words on each of them. So here, the way I've set this up is this is the most number of words, 339. The smallest number of words, the fewest words, was 180. And then I sorted it so that they go up higher and higher and higher, up to 332, right? But 339 would have been the very highest. And I did this just so these are conveniently next to each other, because we'll want to know, we'll want to compare those numbers in a little bit. All right. So there's a lot of different values here. And so creating a frequency table that had a different row for each value in between these two numbers would just be a super long table, and it would be, I don't know, think there's any repeat numbers in here, so they'd all be ones, and it actually wouldn't really summarize the data any better than this would. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna create something called a grouped frequency table, which will help us to summarize this data a little bit better than a regular frequency table would. All right, so we're going to start off the same. All right, so we're going to have one column for the scores, but it's actually going to be ranges of scores. And then another one for the count or the frequency. So the way we want to set this up is that we're going to create ranges of the number of words, and then we're going to count how many of these are in those within that range. Right, and we want to do this strategically so that somebody looking at the table can make sense of it. So we don't want to have too many rows, too many of those groupings, and we want them to be on numbers that are pretty easy for them to understand intuitively. Right. So for here, the highest number, right, so for this top category, is 339, and the very bottom is 180. So we have to have categories that include all of those numbers. So what I'm going to start off doing is I'm just going to figure out the difference between these two, because that's the range we have to fit in between here. All right? So maybe 159. So there's 159 values in between 180 and 339, and we have to fit them all in a little table here. So we got to figure out how many rows, how many of these groups do we want? And so it's kind of nice to have a pretty round number. So what I'm going to do is 159, that's an awkward number to work with. I'm actually just going to adjust this. I want to make it bigger so that we make sure we get all of these. I'm going to make it 160, because 160 is a way easier number to make categories with. 160, if I look at that, I'm like, well, let's see, what could we do with that? We could do 10 rows. With groups of 16 each. Another thing we could do is we could have 8 rows, and they would have 20 values each. And I think that's going to end up being nice, because if we can have these groupings end with round numbers, each one, that'll be easier for somebody who's looking at this to make sense of. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to go with intervals of 20, and it'll end up being 8 of them. Okay, so first we want to set it up. So we want to make sure we get this in here. So this will be 20. So it needs to go up to, would that be 340? We'll have it go down to 320. I'm going to write this a little bit differently. That's really what it means. I'm going to write it as 339, but really it's 339.99999. I'm going to write it this way so it's a little bit easier on the eyes, right? So then if we're going to go down 20, this one will be 300 to 319.99999, 320, right? So this continues up here to 80 to 299.999, 260 to 279, 240 to 259. I'm going to get down to fit 180, 220 to 239, 200 to 219, 180 to 199. Okay, so all of our values are going to fit into one of these intervals. So now we need to figure out the frequency, the number of scores that fits within each one. So if we start with 320 to 339, so I'm going to start, well, maybe I'll start at the bottom, might be easier, because then we could just go left to right. So between 180 and 199, there's just this one score. So for that interval, there's only one score. Between 200 and 219, we have one, two. There's two scores. Between 220 and 239, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 scores there. Between 240 and 259, 1, 2. There's 2 scores there. Between 260 and 279, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 scores. Between 280 and 299, 1, 2, 3, 4. Between 300 and 319, 1, 2. And between 320 and 339, 1, and can't forget this one, for 2. Okay, there it is. That's our grouped frequency table. And this actually nicely summarizes our data set. All right, there's not too many at the ends. There's probably a bit of kind of a grouping towards the middle. There's a relatively low grouping here. But that gives you a sense, at a glance, how the scores are distributed. Right? But we can also do a histogram with this group data. So again, we're going to need, I'm going to create a little more space here, maybe this is, right, we'll need our vertical axis for our frequencies and our horizontal axis. And these are the number of words on the essays. And the highest frequency is 6, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We'll start with the lowest number. So we have to decide what numbers to put down here. And to do that, we want to have it be as intuitive for the reader as possible. And so what I'm going to do is in between 180 and 200, right in the middle, there's 190. So I'm going to put that right there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to center this bar on top of that, 190. Right, so then the next one would be, using the system, 210. That goes up to 2, pretty close to 2 anyway. Then 230 goes up to 6, all the way up. That was 230, so next is 250. It goes up to 2. 270 goes up to 4. 290 also goes up to 4. 310 goes up to 2. And then 330 goes up to 2 also. Okay, so here's a nice visual way to represent this data. It's way easier to look at this and get a sense of what's going on than it is to look at this. The table is actually better than this too, in my opinion. But I really like to see data in a histogram like this because it really gives you a sense, just at a glance, where everything is distributed. Right, there's a big point here, a couple big points here, and otherwise it's spread out pretty evenly. This is a histogram of the number of words on the essay. And again, these distributions are a core concept that we're going to be working with all semester.